To heat and cool buildings takes up an astonishing 40% of energy used across the world. It is a figure that grows only more troubling as climate change continues to threaten the planet. There is an architect who is trying to change not only how much energy a building consumes, but how much it produces. From PBS station WGBH in Boston, Cristina Quinn has this story. It's part of our ongoing coverage of Arts and Culture Canvas.
On a quiet residential street close to Harvard, this pretty nondescript house is known as House Zero.
Why is it called House Zero?
Well, because there are a lot of zeros, right? One is the building doesn't almost use any energy from heating and cooling, and it's zero carbon. It doesn't have any electrical light during the day.
No lights, no HVAC system, and barely a utility bill. The goal of House Zero is to produce more energy than it consumes, ultimately providing power to the grid. Architect Ali Malkawi of Harvard Center for Green Buildings and Cities says it relies only on fresh air and solar energy, and it's quiet.
It is because we don't have any pumps, nothing is moving. It's very much linked to the outside where windows open and close. It's very gentle.
Right, there's no hum, there's no room hum.
Nothing.
There's no machines whirring. It is very quiet, but it's comfortably quiet.
It's amazing because we don't notice this unless we see that we are living in environments such as this, mm-hmm. right? Because most of our environments have these humming noises and
right.
we get accustomed to it.
Windows open automatically if it starts to get a little warm or stuffy, and they're framed by panels that provide shade. The solar chimney makes sure the inside stays ventilated. During extreme temperatures, geothermal pumps are used to cool or heat the house through the floors.
But what exactly is a solar chimney?
It's a chimney that allows air to move freely without mechanical systems. It allows air to be drawn from the outside and people to be ventilated without mechanical systems in the lower parts, where you cannot do cross ventilation.
All of this, though, relies on really smart technology. Under the floors and throughout House Zero, there are 5 miles of cables and hundreds of sensors capturing data like airflow, temperature, and CO2 levels. Put on a pair of augmented reality goggles and you can actually see it.
Now, all the information that we are getting from the house is being pulled into a giant database.
No one actually lives here. House Zero is a lab designed to help the next generation of architects design and build houses that don't rely on energy. Malkawi wants students and researchers to think of buildings as living, breathing structures that interact naturally with their environment.
We're basically demonstrating in this building that just natural ventilation is such an easy thing to do, but can it be controllable? And at the same time, we're saying, okay, now this is good. Can we even go beyond that? Can we scale it up, right, with using very simple technologies?
While the cost of incorporating this technology into a new house would not significantly add to its price, Malkawi and his team are still developing the software to make it ready for the mass housing market. As people become more concerned about their carbon footprint, many elements could become standard in architectural design. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Cristina Quinn in Cambridge, Massachusetts.